Ever wondered how creatine works on our muscles? Well, let's begin by understanding what creatine is. This naturally occurring compound can be found in small amounts in foods we consume daily, like meat and fish. But that's not the only source of creatine for our bodies. Our body is a remarkable machine, synthesizing creatine primarily in the liver, kidneys, and pancreas. So why is creatine so important? Its primary role is to supply energy to cells, particularly muscle cells. Think of it like fuel for your muscles during high-intensity, short-duration activities. Whether you're lifting heavy weights or sprinting, creatine is the unseen powerhouse helping your muscles perform at their peak. Now you might be wondering, how does creatine work on our muscles? Is it magic? Far from it. It's all science, and quite fascinating science at that. So how does creatine work on our muscles? Let's delve into the science. At the heart of it, creatine helps regenerate ATP, the primary energy currency of our cells. Now let's break that down a bit. During intense exercise like sprinting or weightlifting, ATP, or adenosine triphosphate, gets broken down to release energy. It's this energy that fuels your muscles and keeps you going. But there's a catch. ATP stores are limited and can deplete quickly during high-intensity workouts. That's where creatine steps in. Creatine phosphate, a form of creatine stored in your muscles, steps up to the plate, or more accurately, donates a phosphate group to ADP, adenosine diphosphate. This quick donation helps to regenerate ATP almost instantly. And voila, your muscles have a rapid energy source ready for some more high-intensity contractions. So, in essence, creatine acts like a reliable backup generator, ensuring your muscles never run out of the energy they need to perform. That's how creatine aids in ATP regeneration, but there's more to it. By replenishing ATP stores more rapidly, creatine can increase your capacity for high-intensity exercise. Now let's unpack that. When you're pushing yourself to the limit, whether that's sprinting, lifting heavy weights, or climbing the steepest hill, you're relying on ATP for energy. But these ATP stores deplete quickly during high-intensity activity. That's where creatine steps in. It's like your body's very own pit crew, working tirelessly to replenish the ATP stores, ensuring your muscles have the energy they need to perform. This rapid regeneration of ATP means you can maintain high levels of strength and power for longer periods. You can lift heavier, run faster, jump higher, and the benefits don't stop at performance. By supporting high-intensity training, creatine can also help you make greater strength gains over time. So, creatine not only aids in energy production, but also enhances your strength and performance. But what about its effect on muscle size? Creatine supplementation can cause intracellular water retention. Here's why. Creatine possesses an osmotic effect, meaning it has the power to draw water into muscle cells. Now imagine the muscle cell as a sponge. When you introduce creatine into your body, your muscles soak up both the creatine and water, similar to how a sponge absorbs liquid. This process leads to what is known as intracellular hydration, an increase in water content within your muscle cells. As more water rushes into your muscle cells, another phenomenon occurs: cell volumization. Picture your muscles as balloons. The more water they absorb, the larger they inflate. This influx of water causes your muscles to appear fuller, and in some cases it may even temporarily increase muscle size. But the effects of creatine on muscle growth don't stop there. Some studies suggest that creatine supplementation may enhance muscle protein synthesis. Now, what exactly is muscle protein synthesis? Well, it's the process your body uses to repair and rebuild damaged muscle fibers after a workout. By enhancing this process, creatine supplementation can contribute to muscle growth and further intracellular water retention. It's important to clarify that the water retention caused by creatine supplementation is primarily intracellular, occurring within the muscle cells themselves. This is different from extracellular water retention, which happens outside the cells and can cause bloating or puffiness under the skin. So, if you're worried about looking bloated from creatine, rest assured, the water is being stored in the right place, inside your muscles, where it can help improve performance and promote growth. So while creatine may cause short-term weight gain due to water retention, it's generally considered a beneficial effect of creatine supplementation for enhancing muscle performance and growth.